Good morning. Today we are starting with organ-specific and tissue-specific manifestations. Now, disease-causing microbes, they enter our body by different means and goes to different organs and tissues. Microbes, when they enter our body, they can be through nose, they can be through mouth, or they can be through sexual organs, or they can be through mosquito bites also. So, whenever any infectious agent enters our body through different means, they reach specific organs and they cause a particular type of infection and disease in our body. So when microbes, they enter through nose, they most likely to go to the lungs and they affect our respiratory system, like tuberculosis. ठीक है, tuberculosis और respiratory diseases में कोई भी microorganism, it can be bacteria, it can be virus, they enter through the nose and they reach our respiratory system, especially the lungs. So if microbes, they are entering the body through mouth, through contaminated food, water की वजह से अगर वो हमारी body में enter कर रहे हैं, तो वो bacteria की form में हो सकते हैं, virus, protozoa किसी भी form में हो सकते हैं. So if sometimes they cause typhoid, they cause jaundice and other related diseases which affect our digestive organs, organs first, and then later on the infection spread to the whole body. Viruses like AIDS, they enter our body through sexual contact with an infected person, and they can through the lymph nodes, okay, they do and damage the immune system of the body, and this disease is mostly fatal. Then another, like viruses like of Japanese encephalitis or brain fever, ye mosquito bites se hamari body mein enter karte hain aur ye hamare brain ko infect karte hain. So there are various microorganisms, they enter our body through different means and they affect the specific organs in the body of a particular disease. ठीक है, किसी particular disease में एक particular organ infect होता है और उसके बाद वो disease हमारी body में पूरी spread करती है. So this is how this disease, they spread. So sometimes tissue specificity of the infections is also there, like I have told you in the AIDS, it is the HIV, human immunodeficiency virus, which enters, and immune system is a major factor that determines the number of microbes surviving in the body. If you have a stronger immune system, your body will fight the infection, and if you have a weaker immune system, then you may get a disease. So you have to make your immune system stronger by taking healthy diet, proteinaceous diet, and good family healthy diet should be taken for that. Principles of treatment. Now, any type of infection that occurs, it consists of two steps. For whatever medicines are given to you for treatment, first is to reduce the effect of the disease, that is symptoms, fever kam karna, headache, in sabko kam karne ke liye. And the second is to kill the microbes which cause the disease. So to reduce the effect of the disease, जो भी आपको medicine दी जाती है वो आपको effects कम करती है, जैसे fever, pain, loose motion, जो भी आपको symptoms आ रहे हैं पहले तो उनको कम किया जाता है. ठीक है, और दूसरी उस के लिए जो reason है, the reason for that particular symptoms which are happening in your body, उसके लिए जो microbes responsible हैं उनको kill करने के लिए next medicine दी जाती है. So it can be an antibiotic or the drugs which kill that particular specific microbe in your body so that the disease can be cured. So here we'll talk about antibiotics and antiviral drugs also. How do we kill the microbes? One way is to take the medicines to kill the microbes. That microbes alag alag category ke hain, viruses hain, bacteria hain, fungi hain, protozoa hain. And each of these group of organisms will have some essential biochemical life processes which is special to this group, and these processes are actually the pathways to synthesize the new substance or for their process. So unke is pathway ko will not be used by us. If for example our cells, they may make new substances by a mechanism different from that used by bacteria. So we have to find a drug that blocks the bacterial synthesis pathway without affecting their own. So ऐसा कुछ हमें चाहिए जो कि हमारे body को affect किए बिना bacteria के life cycle को stop करे ना body. So that is where so drug that blocks the bacterial synthesis pathway without affecting our own. So antibiotics, they have come into being, we all are familiar with. सिमिलरली देर आर ड्रग्स विच किल प्रोटोजोअन्स सच एज जो एंटी मलेरियल ड्रग्स हमें दिए जाते हैं बिकॉज मलेरिया इज ड्यू टू अ प्रोटोजोन सो दे आर रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर किलिंग द मलेरियल पैरासाइट इन आर बॉडी. नाउ वन रीजन वाई मेकिंग एंटी वायरल मेडिसिन इज हार्डर देन मेकिंग एंटी बैक्टीरियल मेडिसिन इज दैट वायरसेज हैव अ फ्यू बायोकेमिकल मेकेनिजम्स ऑफ देयर ओन. They enter our cells, they use our machinery for their life processes. This means that there are relatively few virus specific targets to aim at. Now, there are very effective antiviral drugs also. So, drugs that keep HIV infections under control, they are antiviral drugs. Now, vaccines are also available to fight these infections in the prevention. We'll be talking about vaccines in preventions. Now, principles of prevention is the last topic of this chapter that we are starting with. Now, we know that we deal with how to get rid of the infection and who has the disease, and there are limitations to this approach dealing with the infectious disease. The first is that once someone has a disease, so their body functions are damaged and may never recover completely. Second is that treatment will take time, and which means that someone is suffering from a disease is likely to be bedridden for some time, and then we give them proper treatment and all. And the third is that person suffering from an infectious disease can be a source of infection and it can spread to others also. So how can we prevent the disease? There are two ways. One is the general and another is specific. General ways of preventing disease. Now, general ways of preventing disease means most related to preventing exposure. And how can we prevent exposure to infectious disease? If we look at means of spread, we know that we have easy answers. For airborne microbes, we can prevent exposure by providing living conditions that are not crowded. And for waterborne microbes, we can prevent exposure by providing clean drinking water. ठीक है, अगर वाटर बॉर्न डिजीज है तो हमें वाटर की तरफ ध्यान देना पड़ेगा. वेक्टर बॉर्न डिजीज है तो हमें क्लीन एनवायरनमेंट की तरफ ध्यान देना पड़ेगा. मॉस्किटो ब्रीडिंग प्लेसेस को हटाना पड़ेगा. पब्लिक हाइजीन की तरफ ध्यान देना पड़ेगा. सो इन एडिशन टू दीज इशूज दैट रिलेट टू द एनवायरनमेंट, देर आर सम जनरल प्रिंसिपल्स टू प्रिवेंट दीज इन्फेक्शन ऑल्सो. Now, why do we look at? Normally, we are faced with infections every day. If someone is suffering from cold, we are likely to get the infection. So, we do not actually suffer from the disease. Why not? We can. So, this is because the immune system of our body is normally fighting the microbes. So, specific ways are there for by vaccination. ठीक है, वैक्सीन्स और इम्यूनाइजेशन प्रोग्राम्स फॉर वेरियस डिजीजेज दे हैव ऑलरेडी बीन डन इन आर country and still they are going on. So our immune system has to fight the microbial infections. When this system first sees the infectious microbe, it kills the microbes and remembers it. So our body works on memory. So if the microbe enters the body the next time, so our body responds vigorously, and vaccines mimics the infectious microbes and strengthen our immune system and protect the body from infectious diseases. So for COVID-19 also, we are waiting for the vaccine. Till the vaccine arrives, we have to take precautions also. So we have to keep taking precautions till the vaccine is ready. So that's all for today, for this chapter. We are completing chapter 13 today with this last topic. I hope everything is clear to you by now. Thank you so much.